Hello everyone out there. Today I will show you a recipe of how to cook grilled lamb chop with herbs. And I have developed this recipe for many years and I would like to share with our people out there. And you can see all ingredients on the list that I wrote down for you. And here's all the list, and we need the lamb chop that you can buy them from Sam Club. They usually have them in the store. First, when you get the lamb chop, you buy them from Sam Club or anywhere else, and we will remove the cover, and we take the we try to clean it up and wash them, make sure the meat is clean before we marinate any seasoning. Today, I bought 4 racks of lambs today. And first, we will rinse with water to clean up any residue, any stuff that not clean before, like 2 or 3 times with water. After that, we put them in the small rack and we will wash them again. After that, we will put salt in there. The salt will shake in, spring around all the meat of the lamb chop. Next, and I would like to add some vinegar. The vinegar is help to the smell of the lamb chop and they remove any odor of the meat. People very worry about when they cook lamb chop, because if we don't do it right, the lamb can cause the smell really bad, and then you cannot even eat them. So I already tried this recipe many years. I found out the lamb chop clean with vinegar combination with salt, they will help the lamb chop meat the smell very good. So I will clean up real good, make sure the meat is clean. And you can see that I had to wash the lamb chop meat like 2-3 times again. Okay, and I clean very good. Make sure you clean them well. And I clean every single rack of the lamb meat, like you had to go and get it. And you can feel that is the fat and the muscle of the lamb. Now I use the scissor to cut the extra fat that wrap around the muscle and the rib cage of the lamb. Some people, they want to leave it because they can, when they grill, they give more juicy to the meat, but I remove a little bit, but not totally remove, because we want to make sure leave some fat on there, so when you grill, the fat will get melted and they make the muscle, the meat of the lamb chop be more moisture, not instead of too dry. And you see, I will remove some of that fat outside of the lamb chop meat. Okay. I will use a sharp knife to cut the little opening between the rib of the lamb chop meat. And this opening will help us to marinate. When I marinate the seasoning will get inside the meat. It gives the meat more flavor. And we will cut this all for all the lamb chop. Now, the next, we will seasoning them, marinate them. The first, we use the fajita seasoning. This fajita seasoning, you can get them from Fiesta, supermarket, or Sam, or Walmart. They do have them at the store. Even HEB or Kroger, they also have the fajita seasoning. And this is very good for the meat marinade, especially beef or lamb chop. And I found out it don't have to be fajita, it can be lamb chop. And we sprinkle the seasoning both sides of the lamb meat. And the next, we will add some manchu steak seasoning. The manchu steak seasoning, also they have a lot of spice and a lot of like black pepper, garlic, and other seasoning in there. And I sprinkle the manchu steak both sides of the lamb chop meat. That will help add more, enhance more flavor for the lamb. Then I will sprinkle them both sides. That's the same way we use to sprinkle for the fajita seasoning. So make sure both sides of the meat will have this manchu steak seasoning. And this manchu steak seasoning, you can get them from Kroger, Sam's Club, Walmart, and this store, HEB, also have them too. So I try to share with you that very easy to get to buy this seasoning. After that, we will add some more Thai leaf. The Thai leaf is the one that it gives the lamb chop meat the flavor of the herbs, and they very smell very good. They very good, and it help. Usually the Middle Eastern people use them for medicine too. So these herbs, and also we had to have rosemary. Rosemary is a must to have for the lamb chop meat. They smell, remove any smell of the lamb. And rosemary, you can sprinkle them both sides, and they will give you a lot of flavor. And you like more, you can sprinkle more, but you can sprinkle both sides and make sure you have that rosemary both sides marinate the lamb chop meat. Next, and I will add some sesame oil to make the meat more juicy, and it's not dry when we cook or we barbecue them or we put on the grill or even in the oven. And so we turn around the meat both sides to make sure the oil get wet all around the lamb chop meat. And also, I will add some vegetable oil or olive oil into the meat. It makes the meat more marinate, fresh, and also juicy. Now, today I don't use oil. I will use sesame oil, and we add some regular vegetable oil around all the marinated meat, and we will soak. We turn around and we make sure the oil get wet for all the meat. After that, we just keep mixing around both sides of the lamb chop meat to make sure it's marinated evenly both sides. I use the glove to mayonnaise to make sure we rub all the oil, the rosemary, the thyme, and the seasoning, all the spice into the meat of the lamb chop. And we let it set. After that, we will let it set to be marinated 30 minutes. You can put it in the refrigerator or you can leave it outside. Today, I leave it outside because the container I have is a little bit too big for my refrigerator. And look at how beautiful the meat with juicy and wet and off everything ready. After that, we will put in the oven and make sure you turn on the oven, preheat up to 350 degrees. And I forgot to tell you that we add a little sugar to the end to make sure they neutralize the salty of the marinade. See, the oven ready. Now, I will show you, we bake the meat like 40 minutes in the oven. So after we bake them 40 minutes, and then we take the foil, aluminum foil paper out, and look at how the meat bake after it's baked 40 minutes in the oven. They're not done yet, they're not cooked yet. After we bake, and then now we put them back to the oven to broil them for 15 minutes for each side. After 15 minutes, you turn around, you flip them, we cook, broil them another 15 minutes. And look at this, after 15 minutes, how that lamb chop look. They turn to be brown color and they look very nice. And we take out from the oven and make sure you cook both sides. And now we cut the lamb chop meat and we will show you the lamb chop meat is cooked. And it's juicy, it's not dry, it's not overcooked. This is done.